Shalom and ברוכים הבאים to another episode of Chizuk Emunah, where we look at objections to the Jewish Messiah, Yeshua HaMashiach. Specifically, we look at the identity of the Jewish Messiah, and today I have a special guest with me here in Canada, Rabbi Yechezkel. Shalom, Rabbi Yechezkel, how are you doing? And I understand you wrote a book called HaEmunah HaAmitit, which means what?
That means the true faith.
The true faith. So I got to ask you a question. This is objection that we always receive, or we receive always a flavor of this, and here's the objection. Let's see how we can address it, and maybe your book helped to address it. It says this. Messianic Judaism does not represent authentic Judaism. Any idea that connected Jesus or Yeshua as the Jewish Messiah cannot be authentic. How would you answer that?
That's a good question. The thing is that how does Judaism define itself according to being authentic? In a sense, does Reform Judaism represent authentic Judaism? Does conservative, humanitarian, Reconstructionist, and even Orthodox within the split factions of Orthodoxy, such as the various Hasidic dynasties, each of them have a different perspective of what they believe is real Judaism. And when you get within that, those cores and values, you see that there's a difference of opinion. Though there's a single line of what defines a Jew within Judaism, they still do not have a simple principle. For us, you would say in relation to belief in Yeshua. We have to take a look at the Judaism in Yeshua's day. And we have to understand it from the framework of that day. Was it within the framework of Judaism in that day? And if that's the case, then we are still within the framework of Judaism.
So in essence, it's important for everybody to understand there is not a single occurrence in the New Testament, correct me if I'm wrong, where somebody came to Yeshua or to his disciples and tell him, hey, you're no longer a Jew.
Exactly.
And matter of fact, the opposite has happened. They say, how can a Gentile come in Acts 15? How can even a Gentile believe that? But this accusation that is thrown around often by the anti-missionary groups to say, you are no longer Jewish because you have a faith in this Mashiach, did not hold ground 2,000 years ago. Is that?
No, absolutely not. We take a look in the Brit Hadashah, the New Testament. We see that when Yeshua actually had a dialogue with the Purushim, the Pharisees, and the scribes, they actually never accused him one time of being something that was not a Jew.
Exactly.
We see that actually they took issues with him regarding what we would consider halachic issues, Jewish law and interpretation of it, but never once did they accuse him of being something foreign to the system of Judaism.
Now, here's a hard question. Is Judaism today, would you say is Judaism today would be considered foreign to the Judaism, let's say, of the first and second century?
That's a very good question.
Because we are talking your book called HaEmunah HaAmitit, or the true faith.
Right.
So the question in my mind is, even is the Judaism that is practiced today authentic? Not the Messianic, I'm talking about normative Judaism.
Normative Judaism, traditional Judaism today. I would say that it is not the same. Because if we take a look at when Rabbinic Judaism began roughly in the year 90 in Yavne, we see that Yavne was like a second Har Sinai, a Sinai experience, where we see Moshe in the first Sinai was receiving what we consider the Bat Kol, the voice of God, the Torah was given. And we read, and even in the Talmud, the oven of Akni, the dispute between Rabbi Yehoshua and Rabbi Eliezer, it was as if there was a debate between a paradigm of one school of Judaism versus another. And the Talmud says that the favor was in the favor of the Chachamim, the wise one, of the Rabbi Yehoshua, and they now represent a new form of Rabbinic Judaism. Obviously, it's not the same Judaism as Temple times. It's almost like, imagine the forefathers of America, when they wrote the Constitution of the United States, imagine they based their understanding of the Constitution off the mystical city of Atlantis. They never were there, they never lived in it, they never saw it. And so, many of the Chachamim, the wise ones, they never lived during the time of the Beit HaMikdash, they never saw it. But yet, they had developed a system of Rabbinic Judaism that came well after it. So they do not represent the same Judaism as we claim to represent with believing Yeshua.
I got you. It's important to understand that Messianic Judaism is another branch of Judaism. I do believe in all my heart that Messianic Judaism is authentic Judaism,
yes.
Especially of connecting the Torah. The Torah of Moses, not to leave that behind, and connecting the Brit Hadashah, because the two are really marrying together.
It's true.
Do you see, I guess here's a question, do you see any contradiction between being a Torah observant, you are a Torah observant, between being a Torah observant and following the true faith of Yeshua? Somebody jumped at us at the street today and said to us, well, Paul is endorsing the seven mitzvot. That is your form of Judaism. How would you answer to that?
No, Chav Shalom. God forbid. That's not it. In fact, we see just the opposite in the Berachah Hashah. We see that Yeshua in his zeal, his observance, even his followers, his Talmudim, were so zealous in their observance of the Torah that they went hand in hand. There was no such thing as this Bein Noach conspiracy that's being peddled amongst the Orthodox today. In fact, they were very fully observant of all 613 mitzvot.
And it appears when there is places in the Brit HaChadashah that the Apostle Paul speaks against the Torah, we also have to take it in context. Who is he speaking to?
Yeah, that's true.
He is speaking to Gentiles.
That's right.
And what is the message he is giving them? Do not base your salvation experience on Torah.
That's exactly true.
The message. So it's also dangerous not to take Paul out of context.
That's true, and it's very important. This is why I was approached by one of the famous anti-missionaries here in the city of Toronto.
Okay.
And he took an issue with Rav Shul. And he says that if he was such a righteous Purush, a Pharisee, then why did he seem to go against the orders of his rabbi, Gamaliel, when he said not to harm Yeshua's disciples? And after I clarified everything with him that he was taking things out of context, I said, you failed to understand something about Paul, that even Yaakov, James, in Acts, and then also Kepha, Peter, in his Egeret, his epistle, defended Paul by saying he writes hard things to understand, and many people misunderstand his writings, and they twist the scriptures to their own destruction. So we see here that, yes, Paul wrote in context. I think it's fair that if you picked up a passage of the Talmud, and you took a passage of the Talmud out of context, I'm sure you will have numerous emails and phone calls from various rabbis saying, no, that's not what that means. So I believe it's fair also with us that if you're going to accuse us or Paul of taking things out of context, that you at least reevaluate the context that he's speaking and to understand him from his present day and time.
That is good. And this is the challenge that we have for you today. If you enjoy this lesson, and you're Jewish and you're watching this program, here's what I encourage you to do. Contact us and we will send you an authentic Brit HaChadashah, not one of the translation. We will send you a proper contextual way to read the Brit HaChadashah and evaluate it for yourself. Here's the challenge. If you can find one jot or tittle that go against the Torah of Moses, then it cannot be true. It cannot be authentic Torah.
That's
but there
true.
Isn't one. This is the objection that I have today to raise up. Find us a place where the Torah of Moses and the Brit HaChadashah contradict each other.
That's exactly true.
Are they contradictory?
No, absolutely not.
Absolutely not. So really the Emunah HaChadashah give further validity
yes.
to the Torah of Moses.
Exactly. It clarifies. Because one of the things, you know, the sages wrote that various opinions in the Midrashim and the Jewish writings that when Mashiach comes, he would deliver a new Torah, but not a brand new Torah.
It will be a chidush. It will be a renewal.
He will bring out the meanings within the Torah.
Yeah, I love the way Rashi said it. He said he will bring the internal sweetness of the Torah.
Exactly.
It will give us a different, deeper understanding of Torah.
It's like peeling an onion. It's going beneath the surface to get to the root within. Mashiach is actually bringing the actual true essence of the mitzvah.
So recently I spoke with an anti-missionary and he brought up the point to me, he actually one of the local guides, that Yeshua have not really gave us a new Torah. Mm-hmm. So in a way, in a sense, he's right. Mm-hmm. There was no reason to a new Torah, but what he's done, he's given us a further validity and a better understanding of the existing Torah.
That's right. Exactly
that's
true.
That's it. So what I encourage you to do today is seek carefully and ask yourself this question. If the Judaism that you follow today, if you're from Reform or Conservative or even Orthodox, is that an authentic Torah? What do you do in Yom Kippur? How do you observe the Shloshet HaRegalim? Do you go up to Jerusalem to bring your sacrifices to the temple? We can't do that. In reality, we cannot even exercise today the Torah of Moses the
that's
way
true.
It was meant to be exercised.
That's actually right. In fact, the Chofetz Chaim, he released a book on which mitzvot are relevant for today and which ones are irrelevant.
Well, the scripture said that God is not a man that he should lie.
That's true. Amen.
So we should take this seriously, and we know that God's mitzvot does not change.
Amen.
He made a way for us to observe the mitzvot through Mashiach Tzidkenu. If you enjoyed this program, write us and contact us in the contact information below. We would love to know what we can do to be a blessing to you. Let us know what is your question, what is your objection, what is your complaint, whatever it is, we would like to hear from you. May the God of Israel bless you with much shalom. Shalom and kol tov, l'itraot.